few weekends ago, my friends and I are in Virginia Beach to watch Pitbull and T-Pain live in a concert. The first thing that we did when we arrived is checked in into the hotel that we're staying. And then we got super hungry, so we went ahead and grabbed some food. We were craving for some sushi, and luckily we are staying at the Marriott Oceanfront Resort. So all we have to do is just go upstairs to rooftop to get to Orion's, where they serve amazing sushi and fantastic view of the Atlantic Ocean.
Watermelon salad.
Cheers!
After taking some shots, we're now ready to get into an Uber and head to the concert venue.
This is a repeat here. What's going on?
We have to figure out tickets.
I represent the ghetto across the world, and you represent the hood. Two hands in the sky. I'm sure. And they say they are.
Concert, but the thing is, it took us so many hours to get out of the venue. It is almost 1 a.m. and we are starving. There's not a lot of restaurants open at this hour anymore, so we just went to 7-Eleven, which is close by the hotel that we're staying, to get some food, which is mostly like noodles and stuff.
So this is part of going to the concert. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Picture.
Neo palang next na concert.
I would love that.
So a little fun fact, I actually used to work at that very hotel. I was here in Virginia Beach way back 2015 to do my internship. It is day two of our Virginia Beach getaway, and the first thing I did in the morning is go downstairs to get this really cool, delicious, fruity water that they had in the lobby. I mean, we were drinking so hard last night, so I feel like my body needs this. After drinking plenty of water, I went to the Starbucks at the hotel to grab some coffee and some pastries that I brought up to the room to share.
Mm-hmm.
For our second day here, we stayed at the historic Cavalier Hotel. So we decided to spend the day at the beach club and just lounge and relax by the beach.
Good day.
Hi, lagi.
Access to the beach club is included to your stay at the Cavalier Hotel. And oh my gosh, they have everything that you need here. Some coolers that they also fill with fresh bottled waters, unlimited supplies of towels, and they really have a nice pool area with these cozy cabanas, and they also have full service in the pool area. But we went ahead and went a spot to the beach because it is a beach day today.
Yeah, what we could deny.
They also provide complimentary beach chairs, and they have a staff at the beach that would set it up for you. The only thing that you will be paying extra are the umbrellas. I believe they're $20 per umbrella, and you have to charge it into your room. We went to the deck, which is the beach club's restaurant. They offer really good seafood, and the first thing that I order is an orange crush. This cocktail is very popular here in Virginia Beach. And for my food, I ordered some chicken Caesar salad wrap, but then we also shared some mussels and some delicious calamari. Nizel ordered some fish, so I was able to taste some of that, and it was really good. Oh my God, we have such a great time at the beach and the pool. So for dinner, we decided to go to the oceanfront area and have some more seafood. But before that, we went ahead and checked the courtyard of the Cavalier, and they have an amazing live performance that night. And we're just all so enchanted by this place. Since we decided to go to the oceanfront for dinner tonight, we needed a shuttle that could take us there. So this is also something that the Cavalier offers to their guests. They have complimentary shuttles to the oceanfront.
Poets often use many words to say a simple thing. It takes thought and time and rhyme to make a poem sing.
Wow.
With music. For for dinner, we decided to go to a place called Harpoon Larry's, and it's one of the most popular seafood spots here in Virginia Beach. The vibe is very casual, very laid back, and as soon as you enter, it's giving off that coastal, cool seafood vibes. To start with, we ordered some oysters for the table. I'm not sure if they're local, but they're really good. They're briny, they're buttery, and a few of them are kind of on the sweet side. And for my entree, I had an Alfredo pasta with some chicken and some grilled shrimp. And my friends ordered several items from the menu that we kind of picked and shared on. Some ordered some salads. And Nisal ordered a really good lump of crab cake. Jane got some thigh coconut shrimp that I also tried. So overall, we love it. Stay here in Virginia Beach, so we decided to wake up early to ride some bikes along the boardwalk. So from the Cavalier, we went down to the Marriott to pick up our bikes. I wanted to do a bike ride this morning because I kind of want to reminisce the days when I used to live here in Virginia Beach. This is the same bike route that I took every morning way back 2015. I used to live at the 15th Street and then I would go ahead and bike north here in 39th Street for work. Virginia Beach is my very first home here in the US, so it will always have a special place in my heart. I have so many great memories here, and I met a lot of great people during that journey. After returning our bikes, since we're already here at the Marriott, I made sure to grab some of that fruity water from your lobby. This is a great way to stay hydrated before grabbing some coffee from Starbucks. Couldn't ask for a better way to start our day.
Are they gonna stop? They should.
After grabbing some coffee, we went back to our room and we passed by the very gorgeous houses here at the Cavalier. That's the thing about this hotel. They also have residences, and I can imagine it would be very nice to live out here. I mean, look at that view. For brunch, we met up with our friends here at Tacos and Tequila. This place is right at the Embassy Suites, which is also just across the Cavalier. They serve Mexican-themed food, so I started with some margaritas. classic with some salt on the rim. And then for my food, I ordered some taco bowls, which is also very good.
I feel like it's everywhere.
I don't like horseradish either.
Oh, you don't?
I love horseradish.
Mm-hmm. So,
it depends. The food is really good, although it's not authentic Mexican food, but the views really made up for it. So overall, we're happy. Brunch, we decided to just lounge at the pool and make it an official pool day. We're headed back to Richmond today, but on the way we decided to stop by a Filipino restaurant here in Virginia Beach. It's called Feelings, and it literally gives me Carinderia vibes, where you can just pick whatever you want from the spread of amazing, delicious Filipino food. I ordered some lumpia and some sisig, and then Nizel got a very delicious chicken curry, some dinuguan. And for dessert, we had some cochinta, which is a traditional Filipino dessert made out of rice flour and some lye water, and is typically eaten with coconut flakes on top. This place also sells a variety of typical Filipino kakanin or desserts. I know some of them are mislabeled, but they're very good. And of course, our Filipino food trip won't be complete without sharing a glass of halo halo. This is a very good way to end a very fun trip with my friends. Thank you guys, and see you next time.